Hello my dear friends and welcome to StudyIQ. I am Joycey Joy and today in this lecture we will discuss about the acquisition of Hamleys by the Reliance company. The Reliance retails arm Reliance Brands announced that it is going to purchase the 100% stake in UK based toy maker Hamleys. So in this lecture we will be discussing about this acquisition. We will also discuss about the recent shift in the business for Reliance, and also we will see what is this buyout all about, and we will also understand and analyze the toy market in India, and we will also understand what should be the focus of Reliance after this acquisition. So we will discuss in detail about all these. But before we begin, this is our channel StudyIQ and we are providing pen drive courses for various competitive examinations, including SSC and bank courses, UPSC optionals, SSC JE courses, teaching examination, railway examination, defense examination, RBI grade B, NABARD grade A, UGC NET, UPSC Civil Services Examination, CLAT exams for various state PSEs and also for various professional courses. You can visit our website www.studyiq.com for more details, or you can call to any of these numbers for more information. So let us start. Let us first understand what is the recent shift in the business of Reliance. So Reliance brand is the Reliance retail arm. So Reliance has a retail arm and it is called as Reliance Brands. So Reliance was already operating almost 85 Hamleys stores in India under a licensing agreement. So already they had a major stake or major control of the Hamleys stores in India with a licensing agreement. Now they have decided to purchase 100% of stakes in the UK based toy maker company. So now if we look at the recent shift in the business of Reliance, Reliance purchased fashion and lifestyle brand John Players from ITC, and it also acquired a majority share in the retail from Genesis that had rights to sell major international brands. So here what we see is that over the past few years, especially after the launch of the Jio Communications or Reliance Jio, Reliance Industries has significantly shifted its focus from industry-led business. For example, the oil or the petrochemicals, such type of industries, to consumer facing operations like telecom, retail, etc. So now we will see a shift in the focus of the company. Now with the acquisition of this toy maker company, now Reliance is looking to leverage both the aspects to make its mark in online commerce segment. So it is preparing for a fight in the e-commerce platform with giants like Amazon, Flipkart, etc. So basically, there is a shift in the business of Reliance. So now they are focusing more on consumer facing operations rather than industries. So now we will discuss about the buyout. Now with this acquisition, Reliance will have access to around 167 stores in almost 18 countries. And this decision of acquisition is also important and significant in the sense that this will be the first move of Reliance in order to fight directly with giants like Amazon or Walmart on a global platform. So this is significant. And another significance is to see and understand how the Reliance will take Hamleys brand to the nook and corner of the country through its e-commerce platform. This is because Hamleys plays at the premium end. If you have visited the Hamleys stores or Hamleys franchises, we see that they provide premium quality toys, and these toys are not affordable for a majority of the population in India. So since they are a premium brand, now we'll have to see how Reliance can take this brand to the majority in India, whether they will reduce the prices, make it affordable for the Indian population, whether they'll be able to reach out to the nook and corners of the country. Now if we take the example of Jio SIM or the Jio Communications, Reliance company was able to make a miracle or a magic in this regard, because they were able to take it to the nooks and corners of the country. It even led to a digital revolution in India. So now we'll have to see whether the same miracle will happen in case of Hamleys also. Now this is briefly about the buyout, and now coming to the toy market in India, Now let us understand what is the present situation. So the biggest challenge in toy market in India is the quality. So availability of good quality toys becomes the biggest and the greatest challenge in toy markets in India. And the toy markets also have a stagnant market. It means that the growth of the market is stagnant. It neither grows upwards or comes down. It is almost stagnant. There is no significant growth. Now with the acquisition of Hamleys brand, Reliance will have to make a move in improving the growth rate of the toy market in India. So that should be one motive of the company. And also, if we look at the branded toys availability in the country, 80% of the branded toys are imported. So this fact itself makes this branded toys expensive. So branded toys are very expensive and almost 80% of them are imported also. So price sensitive customers, they resort to toys which are imported from China, which are cheap. So expensive toys are not affordable for the price sensitive customers or a majority of Indian population, and therefore they depend on the Chinese toys, and this has its own implications on quality, also on the dumping or trade scenario in India. Now another factor that impacts the toy market in India is the mobile games. So now if you look at the children, they are more happy with the mobile games than any physical toy. So the mobile games has taken a fair share of attention of the kids away from the physical toys, and this has led to the closure of many stores in India. So this is also another factor. And also the organized retailers, they have cut down their space for toys because the footfalls or the demand for toys have come down because of over dependency on mobile games. So these are all some of the factors that are associated with the toy market in India. And of course Reliance would have studied the conditions of the market, and now they have got their own challenges to address. So one thing that should be addressed is the quality of the toys. That obviously a branded company like the Hamleys can address this issue. But while maintaining the quality, Reliance should also keep a balance between the quality and the affordability, because in India a majority of the people cannot afford such type of quality toys. Now another challenge would be to give a big push to the stagnant toy market in India. So the toy market growth rate is almost stagnant. Now Reliance will have to give a big push to it. So that is another challenge. Now third challenge would be to meet the imports of Chinese goods which are very cheap and which are readily available in the market. So two things, quality and affordability, these two are the important factors that a customer keeps in mind while making a purchase. So quality is assured, but coming to affordability, here is where the Chinese toy market or the imports can replace the domestic production or even imports from other countries or branded imports. So this should be properly handled. Now the fourth challenge would be a transmission or a transfer of attention of kids away from mobile games to physical toys. So this is another major challenge which should be addressed by many other factors. And finally, the task of Reliance would be to provide quality toys to Indians at affordable prices. And if you look at the serious toy retailers in India, they are only Hamleys and Crossword. So there is an absence of a perfectly competitive market. So this can be properly made utilized by the Reliance company. And now with regard to the present status of Hamleys, Hamleys stores are only in the big city. There is no rural or even semi-urban reach for Hamleys stores. Now the task would be to take this branded toys to every nook and corner of the country, provide quality toys at affordable prices. So we will have to see whether a revolution or a miracle happens with this acquisition, as happened in the case of Jio Communications. You can follow my Facebook page for more video updates. You can also write to me at joycy.studyiq@gmail.com for any of your queries and clarifications. Thank you.